stay in the ship no matter what storms you may be going through. What are the storms you're going through, my friend, in your life right now that are making you want to give up? That are making you question the direction of God in your life? Making you want to jump ship and turn back? This is God's word for you today, my friend. Stay in the ship. Storms are inevitable in life. They will come no matter who you are and how faithful and committed you are to God. Whether you follow Jesus or not, you will face storms. Following Jesus just means that He will be with you in the midst of the storms. Not that you will have immunity or be exempted from challenges, but sometimes you may forget this. You may forget that storms are a part of life, especially when it has been a while since you've been through a storm. Yet, even Jesus tells us that storms will surely come. In John, the 16th chapter, the 33rd verse, he says, "I have told you these things so that in me you may have peace. In this world you will have trouble, but take heart. I have overcome the world." As long as you remain in this world, my friend, there will be storms. There will be trouble. There will be trials and tribulations. Things will come to shake your faith and your convictions. You only decide whether you go through them with Jesus or alone. For many people, the last year has been a continuous storm. It seems like it is one thing after the other. You deal with one and another seems to pop up. It seems like you just start getting used to the storm you are in and finding the peace of God in the midst of that storm, and all of a sudden it is something else. Like you can't catch a break. There has been so much uncertainty and loss and change that you may find yourself out at sea, not knowing which direction you are headed and how you ended up there in the first place. But God has a word of direction and encouragement for you today, my friend. What storms are you in the midst of right now? Are you facing storms in your marriage? Does it seem like your ship is about to be broken with you tossed out of it? Sometimes the storms may even make you wonder where God is. They may make you wonder why God is silent through them. Today, I'd like to share a story with you about a few people who went through storms in the Bible and how they dealt with them. In Matthew, the 6th chapter, the 35th verse, we see Jesus give his disciples an instruction. Let's look at what happens after. "That day, when evening came, he said to his disciples, 'Let us go over to the other side.' Leaving the crowd behind, they took him along, just as he was in the boat. There were also other boats with him. A furious squall came up, and the waves broke over the boat, so that it was nearly swamped. Jesus was in the stern, sleeping on a cushion." What does this tell us? Firstly, you can be obeying the instruction of God and still get into storms. Jesus was the one who told them to get into the boat and go to the other side, and yet it seems like they are about to be drowned now while obeying his instruction. Did that mean the instruction was wrong? Of course not. Sometimes, my friend, in the midst of the storms, the devil will try to make it look like the reason why you are going through what you are going through is because you are on your own. God is not in the matter because you missed his will. You can't be obeying God and still be having challenges, so it must mean that you are out of the will and direction of God. He will try to make you doubt what God has said to you already, to get you to change course, to get you to turn the ship around. Yet Jesus was still with them in the boat. The fact that they were facing the storm did not mean that Jesus had abandoned them. You, my friend, may be going through a storm right now, but I want to tell you that God is still in your boat. He has not abandoned you. You are not on your own. You are not facing that thing alone. This is why the psalmist is able to say confidently, "Even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, you are with me." He knew that the presence of God didn't mean that he wouldn't go through the valley of the shadow of death. But he knew that God never abandons him, no matter what it felt like. God, my friend, may not take you out of the storm as quickly as you'd like him to, but he will be with you through it. He will strengthen and comfort you to face it. He will supply all you need if you will learn to rely on him. He will supply all you need If you will rely on Him, if you will look to Him for it. The second thing we see with the disciples of Jesus is that until they took their eyes off the storm and called out to Jesus, He didn't get involved. Until they recognized that they weren't alone and they didn't have to solve everything by themselves, Jesus did not get involved. He stayed fast asleep. Did He not know that there was a storm? Of course He did. But just like the Father does with us many times, He waited to see where they would put their trust. In their knowledge or in Him. Where do you put your trust, my friend, when the challenges come your way? Where do you look to for help? To the Lord or to your plan B? When the Lord has put you on a boat and you begin to face challenges in that boat, do you bring them to Him or do you do everything you can and even abandon the boat for other options you have? No matter the uncertainties, my friend, no matter the pain, no matter the struggle, no matter the storm you may be going through, God is equipped to deal with it if you will bring it to Him. If you will realize He's got more than what it takes to deal with it. Whatever you bring to Him, He will handle. Whatever you bring to Him, He will help you through. It may not happen as quickly as you would desire. It may not happen immediately, but it will surely happen. He has assured you that whatever it is you go through, He has overcome already for your sake. No storm can defeat you. No storm can break you. Don't focus on the waves of the storm, but instead focus on Jesus. In the midst of the storm, my friend, you may not be able to see Him like the disciples were able to hear, but trust and know that He is in your boat. You may not be able to see where you are going, but keep moving in the direction that He last gave you until a new instruction comes. Refuse to let worry or fear consume your thoughts. Refuse to let the devil steal your peace or your joy with worry and fear. Refuse to abandon your sheep for something better because it is facing storms right now. Imagine if the disciples had abandoned Jesus on the boat for another that was heading to calmer waters. They would have ended up at different places with Jesus, both literally and figuratively. Don't abandon your sheep, my friend. Instead, look to Jesus. Trust Him. He will not give you an instruction that will lead you to your destruction. He will not allow you to face more than you can handle. Put Jesus in the middle of the storm, even when you can't see Him. It may not make sense right now to everyone else, but keep following. Keep walking in the direction that He has instructed you to walk. Keep doing what He has given you to do. Stay in the sheep. It may not be bearing any fruit right now, but if you don't give up, He will come through for you. That storm, my friend, will not be the end of you. Rather, God is using it to do something new in your life. God is using the storm to direct your sheep in the right direction. The storms came for you and not against you. The storm is a partner and not an enemy. God, my friend, is bringing out the good from that storm. And when He is done, it will be evident to everyone for His glory. That indeed, what He begins in your life, He is more than able and capable to perfect. May God help you through your storms. May you, my friend, not be stopped by the storm. May you not be frightened by the storms. May you not be distracted by it. May your focus be on Jesus. May you be able to call out and cry for help from the Master in the midst of the storms. May God help you and keep you strong and direct you to your destination. God bless you.